our continuation is charged electrophiles, and I will discuss simultaneously neutral electrophiles. Charged electrophiles and neutral electrophiles. What are charged electrophiles? They have electrophiles has positive charge. Electrophiles has positive charge. Examples we'll see here: Cl plus chloronium ion, Br plus bromonium ion, I plus iodonium ion, NO2 plus nitronium ion, NO plus nitrosonium ion, C6H5N2 plus benzene diazonium ion, NH4 plus ammonium ion, H3O plus hydronium ion. These all comes under charged electrophiles. Why they have positive charge. Okay, next, neutral electrophiles means what? Electrophiles which has vacant orbitals. Examples, by looking examples you can understand. BF3, boron trifluoride. See, boron electronic configuration, atomic number equal to what? 5. Electronic configuration is what? 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. It is ground state electronic configuration. If you write excited, this is valence shell. If you write excited state electronic configuration, 2s1, 2p2. If we look clearly, s orbital has one electron, and out of 3p orbitals, 2 electrons are present in 2 boxes and one vacant orbital is present. So vacant orbital is present, that's why BF3 can act as electrophile. So we can show in front of boron vacant box. So boron trifluoride comes under neutral electrophile. Why? It has vacant orbital. So it always looks to attract electrons. So acceptance of electrons is also called what? Lewis acids. Now second example is what? I don't explain all those. You can understand by looking first example. Boron trichloride, also Lewis acid. Here also vacant orbital is present. Aluminium chloride, here also vacant orbital is present. Next, ferric chloride, FeCl3. Next one, ferric bromide, FeBr3. Next one, zinc chloride, ZnCl2. It also has vacant orbital. Next one, titanium tetrachloride. These are the famous reagents we can use further reactions. So some other electrophiles also are there. In this only, some other electrophiles. Look here. What are that some other electrophiles? Very simple thing. R C double bond O O E T. Here carbon looking act as electrophile. Why here more electronegative oxygen atom is there? That's why bonding electron shifting towards oxygen and carbon will get positive charge. Now one more, amide. This is ester. This name is ester. this name is ester. Next, amide or C double bond O NH2. Here also oxygen is more electronegative atom, that's why pi bonding electron shifting towards oxygen and carbon get electron deficient attains positive charge. This is amide. Amide also electrophile. Next one, anhydride or C double bond O, OC double bond O, R. Here also carbon centers act as electrophiles, and this is called what? Anhydride. These are the functional groups. Next one, anhydride. Next one, aldehyde also electrophile. Ketone also electrophile. It is aldehyde, here H. It is aldehyde. And RC double bond O R ketone also act as electrophile. Okay. These are the electrophiles. Okay. Next one is nucleophiles. Here you should observe that nucleo means nucleus. Nucleus means nucleo means nucleus. Nucleus indicates with always positive. And files means already told you deficient. Deficient means less or less number. So nucleophiles, please define it. What are the nucleophiles? Nucleus deficient species are nucleus deficient species are nucleophiles means what? Nucleus deficient species are called nucleophiles. Or one more example, electron efficient species. Electron efficient species. Efficient means what? More number of electrons. Electron efficient species also called nucleophiles. Or other term is electron rich. So efficient means what? More number, that is rich. Electron rich species are called nucleophiles. So next point, so under nucleophiles, what we need to discuss? Nucleophiles are Lewis bases. Nucleophiles are Lewis bases. Lewis bases. Lewis bases is nothing but electron donors. Electron donors. All Lewis bases, what will do? Electron will be donated. That are electron donors. So total three types of nucleophiles are there. Total three types of nucleophiles are there. So nucleophiles are three types. That are what? One is charged nucleophiles, and the second one is ambivalent nucleophiles. Next one, neutral nucleophiles. So one by one we will study now. First one is charged nucleophiles. So here is just examples only, that's why I will explain comparatively. Next, ambivalent nucleophiles. Ambivalent nucleophiles. Next one is neutral nucleophiles. Neutral nucleophiles. Okay. What are charged nucleophiles? Charged nucleophiles, nothing but they have charge. They have negative charge. They have negative charge. See examples, we'll see now. Fluoride ion, chloride ion, bromide ion. Sir, you told that electrophiles are chloronium ion, bromonium ion, iodonium ion, like that. Now you are telling chloride ion, bromide ion, like that. See, they can act as both electrophiles and nucleophiles. Situation demands. So now fluoride ion, chloride ion, bromide ion, iodide ion, and nitrite ion, NO2 minus, nitrite ion, NO3 minus, nitrate ion, N3 minus, azide ion, OH minus, hydroxide ion, SO4 2 minus, sulfate ion. Next, SO3 2 minus, sulfite ion, OR minus, alkoxide ion. Next, RC double bond O minus, carboxylate ion, SH minus, thiohydroxide ion, S2 minus, sulfide ion. It is sulfide ion and it is sulfite ion, it is sulfate ion. Now these are the many examples comes under charged nucleophiles. Next one, ambident nucleophiles. What are ambident nucleophiles? Nucleophiles which have two donating centers. But at a time, electrons are donated from one center. So nucleophiles which have two donating centers, but at a time electrons are donated from one center. Best example is cyanide ion. See, this cyanide ion we can write like this: C triple bond N C minus, and nitrogen has lone pair. See, when you observe that carbon has negative charge and nitrogen has lone pair, that's why two donating centers are there. But at a time only one center can be donated. Now one more example, thiocyanate ion, cyanide ion. See, many examples are there. I written only one example. We can see ongoing that type of examples. Next, neutral nucleophiles. Nucleophiles which has lone pair of electrons. See here, best examples are, there is no charge, just lone pairs. Ammonia, NH3, nitrogen with lone pair, ammonia. Water, oxygen has two lone pairs. Alcohol, ROH, oxygen has two lone pairs. Next, ether, ROR, oxygen has two lone pairs. These comes under neutral nucleophiles. Next reagent is what? Next types of reagents. Two reagents completed. One is electrophile and other one is nucleophile completed. Next one, free radical. Third one is free radical. free radical. So what is free radical? Atoms are grouped with unpaired electrons. Atoms are groups. Atoms are groups with unpaired electrons are called free radicals. Examples: hydrogen radical, chlorine radical, bromine radical, methyl radical, etc. So students, in today's topic I completed what? Type of electrophiles, type of nucleophiles, and free radicals. So types of reagents over. Next our topic is types of electronic displacements. Types of electronic displacement. Type of electronic displacement. The first is inductive effect. Inductive effect. Okay, next class we will discuss this topic. Thank you.